Live team coverage of Caitlin Clark's chase for history tonight on Iowa's News Now. Clark just 66 points away from becoming the all-time leading scorer in women's Division I basketball. Kaylee Whitlatch checking in on those ticket prices for Hawkeye Hoops as Clark closes in on the record. But we're going to start tonight with Owen Sebring. He is live at Carver Hawkeye Arena for us. Owen, Caitlin's an icon. She's changing the game. She is also probably not dropping 66 tonight, but I won't put anything out of the realm of possibility. A big game tonight, though, could really set the table for maybe a record-breaking day over the weekend. We'll keep the fingers crossed.
Yeah, Mitch, the list of names that have fallen in Caitlin Clark's wake are a veritable who's who of the best to ever step on a college basketball court. You've got Maya Moore, Elena Deladon, Brittany Griner, heck, even Ashley Jones and Lori Bauman, a couple of native Iowans who are still in the nation's all-time top 10. Yes, Caitlin has firmly entrenched her name among the list of all-time greats, and now as she stands on the doorstep of history, just 66 points away from breaking Kelsey Plum's Division I scoring record, Caitlin acknowledges her place in hoops history. After breaking Kelsey Mitchell's Big Ten scoring record last week, she spoke about what it means to surpass some of the names on the all-time scoring list.
The names that I get to be around, those are people that I grew up watching, especially Kelsey Plum, Brittany Griner, Kelsey Mitchell. Those are really, really great players, people that are still playing our game at the very highest level and people that you watch night in and night out. And Coach Bluder, obviously, it's kind of what she pitched to me when I got recruited 4 years ago is, you know, we play a fast, up-tempo offense and, you know, you're going to kind of have the ball in your hands. And, you know, she's kind of just let me thrive and be me. And there's, you know, not a lot of coaches out there that would probably allow that every single night. So, you know, I'm just very thankful.
Now, earlier this week, Kelsey Plum, who played at Washington, she's the current record holder. She spoke about Caitlin's pursuit of her record, and she says that she's actually grateful to pass the baton, and she's happy for Caitlin, but also issues a word of warning, saying that her pursuit of that record was actually the low point in her life, and she let too much of her identity be caught up in that pursuit of that all-time scoring mark. And she warns fans and viewers that if you're going to show Caitlin love off the court, if you're going to show Caitlin love on the court, then you should also show that love to her on the court as well, because she's a young woman with feelings and emotions, she says. Reporting live from Carver Hawkeye Arena, where the Hawkeyes are going to tip off against Penn State at 8 o'clock tonight, I'm Owen Sebring, Iowa's News Now Sports.
Owen, thank you. We'll keep our team coverage going with Iowa's News Now reporter Kaylee Whitlatch, also live in Iowa City tonight. Kaylee, Iowa women's basketball tickets, season tickets sold out real quick after Bluder's Bunch made that run to the national title game in the spring. So they were already a tough get. Now you add in this chase for the scoring record, those prices are really starting to climb high.
That's right, Mitch. If people want a seat to catch a glimpse of Caitlin Clark and the women's team, they'll have to pay hundreds of dollars to resale websites. And students here tell me that they go on social media in hopes of catching some cheaper tickets and or they will just enjoy the game watching TV. Caitlin Clark is making history in the Hawkeye State.
I think everybody, you know, is willing to pay a lot of money to see her go to work, basically.
And in the world of college basketball.
Our team is really good. Of course, Caitlin Clark has, like, so much talent, but the whole team has so much talent, too. Like, it's a whole team effort.
Paying for a seat inside Carver Hawkeye Arena can cost big bucks. The cheapest resale ticket for Thursday's game against Penn State range between $70 and $100 each, and the most expensive going around $600 to $800. While ticket prices can fluctuate, as time goes on, some fans have no choice but to watch the game from home.
So my parents tried to get tickets and they were like maybe like $300 a piece, and it was just a little too high. They watch every game on TV.
The success of Caitlin Clark and the second ranked Iowa Hawkeyes make it all too appealing for people to be in the room where it happens.
She like makes everybody proud to be a Hawkeye. It's great watching her out there. It's like awesome what she's doing for the sport, and she's going for number one. We're all waiting for it. It's going for number one. It's going to be a good day.
As Clark is on track to break more records, fans are just hoping for more wins and possibly some championships this season. Anything else you want to add?
Go Hawks!
Go Hawks!
Let's go Hawks!
And one college student here tells me that there are student-only social media groups that students can get on and access some cheaper tickets that are substantially lower. Live in Iowa City, Kaylee Whitlatch, Iowa's News Now.
Smart college kids finding a tertiary market, I suppose it would be. Just three more home games in the regular season for Iowa women. They host Michigan a week from tonight, Thursday the 15th, and they wrap up with Illinois on the 25th, Ohio State on March 3rd. Both of those are Sundays. Iowa's also probably hosting a pair of NCAA tournament games, too. Hawkeyes are projected as a one seed right now. The top 16 teams in the field host the first two rounds.